Hey, so I wanted to show you guys another thing with our water. Right now, it's not raining, and also the water line that comes down from higher up in the mountains where some lakes are and where it rains constantly, the water line itself is broken. And so Umbungig actually has no water right now. So it's rather rough, especially when you only have a couple drums that you can fill up. So what we have are several of the 5-gallon jugs of water. We got five there, I got another one over there, there's another one in the bathroom, and I think there's one upstairs. So what we have to end up doing is we put them all in my Jeep, and we drive down to where a natural spring is, where they put hoses in to tap into the spring, and we just fill all of them up. So it takes a while, but it's what we have to do if we want to have water during times like this when it's not raining and the water line is broken. Even when the water line is not broken, though, it's not always the water is not necessarily consistent, and we're actually borrowing water from somebody else. So they fill up their water first, and then if there's still water running, we can fill up as much as we can. Usually, though, the water doesn't last long enough for us to fill everything up. On the few times it does, we fill up all four of our drums, and we fill up all of the 5-gallon jugs of water so that we know that we'll have more water. I think we have 7 or 8 drums of, or 7 or 8 5-gallon jugs. So it gives us, 35 or 40 gallons of water, which is almost one drum. And so it helps us out when we can fill everything up. But even when we can't, it gives us enough water so that we can cook and clean for a couple days and take our baths and whatnot. It's a hard thing sometimes when you're cooking, or actually before you cook, you have to look at the water and say, okay, how much water do I need to cook? How much water is it going to be to clean the dishes? How many dishes can I use so that I can save the water? And require me to again. So, it's quite a chore. Anytime we do anything with water, we have to consider how much it's worth it. Is it worth taking a bath today? Am I just going to be by myself? Did I take one yesterday? Okay, I don't really need one. Oh, it's been 3 or 4 days. I probably need to take one, even though there's not very much water. It's a chore. And so I just wanted to share that with you as well. And, maybe you can help by praying for water. Honestly, God answers prayers. And it's something that this community doesn't have a good supply of. So, anyway, I just wanted to give you that information, and I hope you guys are doing great. And don't take your water for granted, because honestly, it stinks not having water. Literally, stinks. Can't flush a toilet anytime you want. Can't do dishes all the time. Can't take baths all the time. It reeks. Okay, it's not that bad. Actually, sometimes when we know we haven't had water in a while, we're not going to have it, we'll just go down to the river and take our bath there. We've only done that a few times when there's been no water for, you know, a whole week or something, and we're completely out. That's what we'll do. So, yeah, start. I want to challenge you to start considering the water that you use. Start considering how much water you actually use for whatever it is, and see if you can actually remember before you do things to consider water. It's a challenge, and so just wanted to share that with you, give you a little bit of experience of life in the room.